As of midnight tonight, we will be requiring that masks are worn in indoor settings. We are encouraging people, particularly over the holiday period, if you can work from home, please work from home. We do want to limit mobility just as we get through this period of time, and particularly in relation to ensuring that our health workers are able to be on the job and provide that care and support for those who are unwell. We'll be moving from we'll be moving for hospitality venues indoors to 2 square meters from December 27 to January 27, and also that indoor face mask requirement will also be in place until January 27 as well. So December 27 in relation to 2 square meters, and that's just to ensure that as we move through this period of time, we do have that support for our health officers over this summer and holiday period. In addition to that, we're also encouraging people not to mingle, and when you're out and you're out at a restaurant, you're out at a cafe, you're out at a pub or a club, please, where possible, don't mingle. We know that from the case that we've seen in Newcastle, that singing and dancing and the like has been a part of that increase in spread. So we just ask everybody, use personal responsibility, please be cautious as we move through this phase. The other aspect arising out of National Cabinet yesterday was the national agreement put in place QR codes. Many of you would be aware we've had those QR codes in place for some time. We kept them in place for high risk settings. What we will do in relation to retail settings and lower risk settings is we will bring them back in a limited way. But if you don't feel unwell, there is no need for that testing to occur. That will help alleviate some pressure on our testing centres right across the state. Obviously, I want to thank everybody who has gone out, close to 150,000 tests a day. The other point I'd make here is in relation to, and thank the other premiers around the country. There are obviously requirements in place at the moment, as the health minister labels it, the tourism testing. I want to thank particularly the Queensland Premier Anastasia Palaszczuk, who's announced that she will remove that requirement and transition to a rapid antigen test from 1 January, because we're seeing in respect of testing around 20% of those tests that are occurring are for the requirement of interstate travel. That is putting substantial pressure, and I'll continue to work with premiers across the state to transition from that system of a PCR test to a rapid antigen test. That will reduce the lines, and what it particularly does, and I say this to the other state premiers around the country, what it does is it ensures that those people who need a test get a test, and importantly, we can get the results back as quickly as possible for those who are sick and unwell. So I thank everybody for their patience. I do know that there has been a fair bit of frustration out there. Many people waiting hours in queues, particularly as we come into Christmas. We're doing everything we can to alleviate that pressure. The two things we can do is move away from that interstate PCR testing. And in addition to that, if you're unwell, so for those people from New South Wales, if you aren't feeling unwell, please do not get a PCR test, because you're taking the place and extending the queue for someone who is unwell and sick at this time, and we need to get those tests back as quickly as possible.